It's Chris with BBTV, and we're at Jamie Moore's gym, and I'm very pleased to say I'm joined by Lerone Harrison, professional boxer, 2-0. It's nice to see you, Lerone. I won't say nice to meet you. I think I remember seeing you when you was a young kid with your dad in the gym. But now it's great to see you here with Jamie, and you've turned over pro and you're a pro boxer on your own journey now, so well done
Got
for
another
that.
One coming up soon as well, May the 14th, I think, in Blackpool. I think it's a VIP show, Steve Wood.
Okay, that's
3-0 hopefully.
Was it always, obviously your dad is synonymous in boxing, as you know, up here everyone knew Oliver. You was obviously around it all your life, but was it always, did you know you was destined to get into boxing and do it to this level?
Yeah, I think so. Even in school, like, obviously I took school seriously, but in the back of my mind I was like, oh, do we even need to be doing this? Because I'll be doing boxing anyway when I get older and stuff, so. Yeah, I always knew that I was going to do boxing, I think, yeah.
You was always around you then, growing up?
Always in the gym, since I was like 2, probably even younger. Mm. I've got a picture of me when I was like 18 months with gloves and a head guard on. I weren't doing anything, but I was just in the gym.
Yeah. Obviously your uncle, Humphrey as well, boxer, right? So it was always in the family.
Yeah.
Did you have brothers and sisters?
I've got a few brothers and sisters.
Were they into the boxing? Or was it always
Lamar,
you?
My older brother, he's started getting into it later on. I think he's had like a few white collar fights and stuff, but he's massive. He's like 6'6" or something. Yeah, my little sister also used to do boxing as well,
right.
But she does like cheerleading and stuff now.
Yeah.
Doing well.
I mean, your dad was so heavily involved in boxing, it was inevitable. It was always, you know, a massive part of your life and his life. Anyway, he was almost at every show, wasn't he? He was always dedicated to the game. Lovely guy, and everyone who met Oliver knew he was a top man. So. You carrying on, I'm sure he'd be very proud of you that you're continuing the name and in the boxing world.
Do you think he would?
Making that decision to turn pro after your dad had passed away and everything and coming with Jamie seemed the natural thing. What made you decide that I'm definitely going to do it and then make that decision?
Well, I took a while off. Like, I took like a year and a half off. I was still training here and there, but I weren't competing and I weren't really taking it too serious, but then I just started missing it, so thought who's the best person to come to. So I went to Jamie and we were talking about like doing a senior season in amateurs, because I never really done a proper one, but just decided to turn pro and take it like fully serious, because I knew if I done another amateur season I wouldn't have been like 2 feet in, but turning pro you have to take it serious, so I thought that was the best thing for me to do.
20?
Yeah, 20.
What did Jamie say to you when you came to him and said, I'm going to give this a go and turn pro?
He really wanted to help me get to the next step in my life. Mm. So
you couldn't have gone anywhere else really, could you?
No.
The right place. Jamie's almost like family then, isn't he? You've known him all your life. He's been there since you was a baby. What about having him as a coach? You know, what's it like? What's the dynamic like as a family member, if you like, to a coach?
I mean, it's not much different to, like, I've been used to having family members as a coach, so I don't know. It's better when you're close to them, obviously, because they know your tendencies and stuff, and they always want what's best for you, don't they? So it's good.
Mm. Your dad was a serious guy as well when it got down to training. There was no messing about in the gym, was there? Do you know, working with Jamie, can you see the familiarities of the styles, and obviously your dad taught him so much in the pro ranks, so
yeah, definitely. And Nige as well.
I've known
Nige for a long time, and he's always here. But yeah, it's mint here at the gym. Everyone here is great. I love it.
All bounce off each other.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's in there with Chantel Cameron doing some rounds there. Nice technical work. I mean, she's quality, isn't she? But we were both saying how well you're both working in there and learning from each other.
Yeah, she's gonna smash it. I think she's the best girl boxer I've ever saw. She's amazing.
What was it like being in there with her doing the rounds?
It was good. We was obviously working on stuff for her fight, and she done me in the last round, can't lie. She done me in. I'm joking.
So 2-0, tell us about the first two fights and how you feel you've...
Yeah, they've both gone well. Not much I can say. They're not the hardest of fights, but the second fight I stepped up a little bit, because he weren't a journeyman, he was 0-1, and yeah, I'm just looking to keep stepping up and stepping up there.
Yeah, yeah. Try to progress every time, get a better opponent as you go.
Yeah, keep getting better.
It's all about learning at this stage anyway, isn't it? Yeah. So I think it's more about regular fights. You know,
yeah.
Keeping in the gym, keep fighting regular, back in the gym, fight again.
I was meant to fight, like, I fought in October, then I fought in December, and I think I was meant to fight in February or March, but I got ill. So now it's May, but it's not unregular fighting, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Still consistent. It's, yeah. Gonna get back into it like every couple of months again or a few weeks, whatever.
And when you look forward, Lerone, what are your ambitions in the sport when you look down the line in a few years?
It's hard to see like the end goal, but obviously I wanna get as far as I can. Everyone wants to be a world champion, I wanna be a world champion obviously, but yeah, I just wanna do the best that I can do, you know what I mean?
Have you got that dedication to the sport, live the life, no distractions?
No.
You know what it takes, you've seen what it takes around
definitely.
You, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, I wish you all the very best. I'm looking forward to seeing your next fight, Lerone, and I'll be following you. I fought a lot of your dad, he was a great guy. I trained with him over the years. He used to let me in the clubs years ago, on the doors and the pubs, I remember that. He'd recognise me and that, he was a good guy. He even refereed a couple of my old fights years ago in his gym.
No
way. So I remember him well, and it's great to see you doing, and I'm sure he'd be very proud of you. So
thank
God
you.
Bless, and I'm sure the future's bright for you.
Nice one, Lerone. Thank you.